content marketing in various forms has been the bedrock of IT marketing. And the reason is because when you are selling largely in a B2B enterprise kind of environment, there's always a lot of convincing that you need to do. And that convincing doesn't come, you know, from advertising or from PR or any of those mechanisms, but it comes from hardcore content that you can put out in various form factors. So of course, what we are seeing now is that, you know, there is a change from long form kind of content. I remember in my early part of my career, we used to write 25 page white papers. That's probably coming down to now 5 and 6 pages. But people still need, you know, some material that they can go through and consume before they even actually get into a purchase. So that's I think the key role that content plays in this whole game. I think content marketing is getting a lot more visual. So we're looking at videos, we're looking at explainer videos, for example, which are becoming really big. People want content that they can look at on their handphones or on the, you know, in a minute or 2 minutes, where they get the gist of the whole thing. So I think visual is certainly a lot of things, is coming in a big way. I think the other thing that's coming in a big way is basically, infographics. In fact, just yesterday I was working on converting a 6-page case study into a 1-page infographic, just to make it more visually appealing, key data points stand out, easy to consume. So I think visual is the trend that I'm seeing. The first thing, you know, that I strongly believe is that in the content game, you have to have people who think content, not necessarily write content. So I think our focus has to shift to thinking content. And what I mean by that is connecting various things to deliver the story. So I think that really is something that people need to focus on. As far as the dissemination goes, I think they need to very, very clearly identify the persona, identify the person they're going to communicate to or the group of people they're going to communicate to, and target the communication to that group. I think that becomes a very important thing that they need to do. I think that these are the two things that I see which are significant in getting positive results. So it's not the traditional, you know, spray and pray kind of approach. It's an approach where you focus and target and deliver the necessary content to people. And that's why you need that architecting function, because people need to kind of mold it to what the end audience needs. That's basically what I see.